We would describe here the Gibbs phase rule when we have chemical reactions taking place. So the Gibbs phase rule tells us how many degrees of freedom we have, and that's what this equation is, that this is the degrees of freedom. And what we mean by that is how many of the variables can we set independently before the system is specified. So C here is the number of components in the system, so different chemical species. P is the number of phases. At 2, this is the number of chemical reactions. And S are constraints, and describe what they are by looking at examples. So the idea is we put in these numbers and we can then determine how many intensive variables. So we're only talking about intensive variables with the Gibbs phase rule. We don't determine the amounts, but instead temperature, pressure, concentrations, or mole fractions are the intensive variables we're talking about. So let's look at an example of a reaction. And the reaction we'll look at is the decomposition of ammonium chloride solid. And we're going to do this decomposition by starting with ammonia chloride and we're in an evacuated container. So no other components present. And we're going to look at ammonium chloride solid, decompose and go to equilibrium, make ammonia gas and HCl gas. And we want to apply the Gibbs phase rule to this system. And so the constraint in this case is that the mole fraction of ammonia, the gas phase, is equal to mole fraction of HCl. In other words, they're not independent variables like they might be in other systems where we have two components. And that's because we're starting with ammonium chloride and watching the decomposition. So we're going to write down the phase rule again first, and then we'll substitute in. We have three components, three compounds. We have a gas phase and a solid phase, so there's two phases present. There's one chemical reaction. These are independent chemical reactions. And there's one constraint, and the other way of looking at it is one additional equation, because the phase rule is just how many variables do we have, how many equations. In this case, we're given one additional equation. So adding up the numbers, this says we have 1 degree of freedom. And so, for example, this would say if we set the temperature of the system, that's it. Can't set any other variables. All the intensive variables are fixed, which would mean the pressure of ammonia and the pressure of HCl are fixed, the total pressure. So once the temperature is set, then it means the decomposition pressure at equilibrium is fixed, determined. We can't independently set that pressure. So the important things that we want to remember about the Gibbs phase rule is we're talking about intensive variables. The Gibbs phase rule is not going to tell us anything about amounts. And when we talk about number of chemical reactions, they must be independent, meaning we can't add two reactions together to get third reaction. And so if we had three reactions like that, only two of them would be independent. So independent chemical reactions, so we can determine the number of degrees of freedom.